I had the time to do another quick one, so I'm gonna talk about degrees of separation. I was reading the Supernatural handbook for Mutants and Mastermind, and they had this. It's a source book for superhero games, but since Mutants and Mastermind is also a generic universal system, like GURPS or Hero or Basic System, you can use it for different stuff. And the Supernatural handbook, really great book, is about creating horror. And funny anecdote, I received the book the day of Halloween, so it's going to be one of those books. And they talk about degrees of separation or degrees, right? Yeah, of separation, and it's such an interesting idea. Explain a lot of things in a short amount of space. Degrees of separation is simply the layers or the distance between you and an inaccessible idea. For example, let's say a game is run in Dungeons and Dragons in using an Asian setting like Oriental Adventure or Rokugan. And then in this setting, you are playing. All players are male, and in the campaign, every character is female. Okay? So then at the table, you have Johnny, the usual gamer, who will just. He's the uber geek. He just sit at the table, take the character sheet. Oh, I'm a girl. I'm in a Rokugan. I play a Scorpion Clan. He knows everything about the background and the setting. So he's just sliding to the character, and boom, he's playing. This guy, uber geek. He know everything about Rokugan and D20, and he know all his stuff. The session is fun for him immediately. Then you have Joe. Joe, poor Joe, it's his first session of role playing. He never played before. You have heard his friend that is very fun, so he tried it. He tried it for the first time. The guy is a football fanatic. You know nothing about RPGs or fantasy or anything. So first for him, there is one degree of separation right there. He doesn't know what RPGs are. Then he doesn't know anything about Dungeons and Dragons or how to play a character. So there is one major degree of separation that separate him from the other guy. So poor Joe now try to play. He rush, he doesn't understand the mechanic. But it's not over for poor Joe. You have a second layer of separation. You have a second degree of separation. This game is set in a specific setting. It's in Rokugan. It's a specific world. So, all right, what's this setting is all about? It's not even about is an historical Japanese society. It's a made-up one. So you have to learn the language, you have to learn the little clans and behavior that are typical to this world. So, two degrees of separation. The guy now is obligated to play a female. For him, it's another degree of separation. He's not accustomed to play a female character. He's a guy, so he think like a guy. He think like a football guy. He think like an objective. Where is the goal? Can I punch somebody in the face? So he will not play this female with all the subtleties and minutiae of what one character. So he's at 3 degrees of separation already, just by sitting at this table. How do you think this game will go for this guy compared to Jim, who just, oh, Rokugan, female, go. Pew. Degrees of separation happens in every fandom. Some people will enjoy Firefly. Oh my god, they will just eat everything Firefly. And for the Star Wars guy, they will say stuff like, yeah, but ships don't even have hyperdrive. How can they go to different planets? They are stuck in real space and relativity speed and sublight speed. So it's a very interesting idea, and when we try to introduce new players to the game, we should have a little thoughts about how many degrees of separation this game is going to have from the point of view of that player in that game. It's a very interesting idea, and I throw it at you because you can use this to introduce people to new games, new idea. And I just understood that I'm doing this for a long time. We are using different games each year. We play a different game each year, and sometimes two different games and three, just for the fun of it. And now my players are well versed in. I fear that if we introduced a new player in my group currently, I would have to be very careful about these degrees of separation, just to introduce slowly that player in, like playing a familiar game of Pathfinder set in a generic fantasy setting like Galarian, where you can make it as vanilla as you can, or Forgotten Realm. Or I will not start to play a Savage World version of Ravenloft with some time travel in it. It's the best way to kill enthusiasm and to lose a player right there, when your idea is very, very specific. I know Fountrodden is trying to propose a game of Maid, the role-playing game. It's a serious thing. When you just remove the word Maid and you look at the game itself, it's a game about Victorian, a pseudo-Victorian era, where you play these anime characters. So you have anime character first. It's 1 degree of separation for people who don't know anime. That's a big one. Big eyes, colorful speech, people who cry with big tears. And then you have Victorian era. If you don't know your Victorian era a little bit, this is weird. This is that. Then it's a little bit steampunk, and maybe have some power. So this game is not for everybody. You have a lot of degrees of separation compared to a game of D&D or Pathfinder. Just because we are used to see the typical fantasy in video games and movies, and it is the most known game. But when you are looking for weird specific game, you have to be very, very nerdy in a sense, but I would say this in a positive way. The more you know about genre, the more you know about different kind of fandom. I'm a huge Star Trek fan, but I'm also a huge Star Wars fan, and I'm also a brown coat, and I'm also a Whovian. Oh god, I'm such a Whovian. So So it's a strength for me as a player to be able to slide into these different slots and just go with the flow, because you know I've spent so much time in my life not doing stuff like physical activity. But point is, I know I study a lot of these fandom, and I'm a fan of many of these fandoms. I'm a fan of DC, I'm a fan of the Marvels, I'm a fan of such, I cannot count them. And I'm and I every time I go deep into this fandom, because it's fun for me, it's an intellectual pursuit. So when you're taking your average player and you propose a game that you want to try, and this game is very, very specific. This guy, I want to play a game of Don't Rest Your Head from these guys at the Evil Hack Company. So just think about in terms of degrees of separation. When you want to ease a new idea or introduce new players, and I think it will help you to make new idea more accessible. So thanks for watching, and until next time.